Now, it would have been cool if, like, in, like, later stages here, since Entropy's not here to make sure the Time Twister's working properly, it would be cool if, like, there was, like, some weird malfunctions in stages or something you saw. But, nah, that's clear. That's just there for a cutscenes and all that. Nothing happens in the game. So, it's kind of disappointing, honestly. I don't think I can even get the box gem in this. And yeah, it's Death Tornado Spin, which basically just makes us spin for a much longer period of time. And if we combine it with the double jump, we can basically glide through the air for a little bit and go past bottomless pits like that. But there aren't any actual boxes here, so. I'm just going here because I don't think we can actually get all the boxes yet. I could be wrong. Come on, you can go through! Yeah, boy. Man, I just can't wait until Insane Trilogy comes out. It's only in 2 months! 2.5 months, man. Like, it's unbelievably close. Like, there was that rumor of it being coming out in February, which, yeah, I'm not surprised that didn't happen. But still, June 30th? That's a decent... loads of people thought it would be, like, Christmas time, and there's still a chance it could get delayed. But I'm keeping my fingers crossed. Like, I think June 30th is a great time for it to come out, personally. Actually, thinking about it, June has quite a lot of stuff. I think ARMS is coming out in June. I could be wrong about that. A lot of Switch stuff is coming out in June, I believe. Alright. No! That was bad. That was kind of shady. Ah, I remember this bonus room being a little bit hard to set up at the end. If this is the one I'm thinking of, anyway. Alright. Nope. Nope. Oh gosh! Alright, I won that life. Alright, we're good. Okay, no, it's another one. It's not this stage. Ooh. Wait. I probably could have gone all the boxes, actually. What did I miss? Is that the star? Dang it, I could... Alright, we're going back. I seriously thought I couldn't get the boxes. I thought there was like a second pathway. So I'm pretty sure that... I think it was a blue gem path. I'm pretty sure it doesn't have boxes in it. So I'm just gonna quickly go through here again. I'll show off this first section because we didn't go to the right. Alright. So yeah, I guess just ignore the left. Like, I don't know what even the point of it is. Like, I guess to get more lives, but you get enough already, and I can't even say speed for speedrun reasons, because this looks like it's a lot shorter. So I don't know. That's gonna close. Pokemon. Maybe it's just me being cautious, but it looked like it was gonna, looked like the walls were gonna close in on themselves. Alright, I'm just gonna cut to the end, because you've seen all the stage, so. Alright, and we got the gem. Okay. My bad about that. Okay. I think the second stage is a jet ski. Oh. Okay. Go to this stage. Alright. I actually kind of enjoy these stages. Like, they're completely different from what you'd expect, but I think they're decently fun enough. Basically, it turns into a plane shooter, and basically, circle is to shoot. Square does a barrel roll, which basically makes you invulnerable, and yeah, these guys can be. Basically, what happens is that when they're facing you and going up directly after you, that's when these guys are gonna start shooting at you, and yeah, just shoot down all these blimps and get the crystal. But we're also gonna get the gem, obviously. So yeah, one thing that's actually pretty interesting is that you can just hit any the balloon or the actual crate, but if you hit the crate dead on, then you'll get the reward. You'll get a life from the health boxes, and you'll get one for free from the normal ones. So that's pretty cool, I think. Yes. Again, it's very different from what you'd expect, having a war setting. I'm pretty sure the crash stage of this is a World War I setting. I don't know if this one is as well, or something else. I don't know. I guess it's World War I as well. Let's see how well we can do at the time trial. This is going to be interesting. Alright, so. That. Get that one. I don't know the best route for these stages, but wait, where's the other one? Oh, there's one over there. Come on. All right. I feel like, yeah, I'm gonna start over actually. Okay, so remember, there's one there. Start one. Don't die. All right. Okay. That should be good. Oh! Even better than good. Alright, I'll take it. Okay. Two cocoa levels just like that. Alright. Now there's actually a secret area that's actually really easy to miss. So I'm gonna just die immediately, okay. Whoa, okay. Somewhere in this section. It has to be. Trying to find an opening, you know? I guess it's not here? I could have sworn it was before this point. Oh, maybe it's this. Like, when I'm pretty sure it's in one of these, like, big open sections like this. Oh no, here we go. Okay, now we're in the gold mine. Alright. Yeah, go away, Arrow. No one needs you. We can just go to the regular pathway and get all the boxes fine. Also, Oh well, it's not this stage, but you need to get, you need to do the nosedive to get that life. But it's basically like, just imagine that, but a box instead. Let's see if I can get it actually. Bad angle. Yeah, no, it didn't work. Oh well. Oh wow, I went really far down with that. Okay, no. What? Did I cancel the animation or something? Because you're supposed to be like, the cannonball end death is like, you're meant to be flying out of your jet ski. So I don't know what happened there, that was weird. Where's the checkpoint, man? Man, those guys, they go way far further than I thought they would. Okay, go away, go away. I'm hoping I didn't miss one. Alright. Alright! Please don't swim in her. Good. Oh, that's a checkpoint. I'm gonna go get that. Alright. Now, I have to remember that there's, I didn't break that box before the checkpoint, so I'm gonna have to go back every time. But if I'm good enough, I shouldn't have to worry about that. It's coming up to the end, and this part shouldn't be too difficult. Okay. Yeah, those guys are actually, well, they aren't too difficult to avoid, but they were pretty annoying as a kid. Again, I just think that the enemies in this game are just a lot more difficult to deal with. Like, even Crush 1, I think. Even, I don't even remember Crush 1 enemies being that much of a problem. The only thing that this game doesn't have are enemies that you have to slide under to defeat. But, you know, those enemies weren't even that hard. They were, you just had to approach them differently. For the time trial. Okay. So I'm not really sure how this is gonna go, but hopefully it won't take too long. Proceeds to miss it completely. I hate how they position this time, this clock in like the side of where you're starting. I guess you can manipulate the stage layout depending on when you hit the clock. But you know. Dang it. Alright, I'm gonna keep going. I'm gonna assume we're fine. I guess I'm kind of being like a bit too general when I say this game is not, the Crash games aren't that hard overall. Well, Crash 1 is definitely still hard for me to even today, but I'd say, it's hard to say because I'm a platforming veteran and there's no telling like how hard it could be for a newcomer. So, I don't know. I guess if I had the ability to like get some new guy to play this game that hasn't played a platformer before, that would be made for an interesting study, but I don't think I'd ever be able to do something like that. Or, because I don't really know that many people who haven't played video games before, so it wouldn't really be the same if they've already played specifically platforms. Like, if they play shooters, it's not exactly the same thing, but yeah. It'd be interesting to see like how they think, how hard they believe Crash 3 is. I've missed so many times. It's probably gonna be bad. Oh. Alright, well, I got proven wrong again. At least we don't have to do it again. I think my favorite state, well not, I don't, it's my favorite theme. And that is Future Frenzy. And I wish there was another level, another future level, because there's only two, and then a death route. If you want to call it that anyway.
We meet again. Uka Uka and Dr. Cortex want me to teach you a lesson. Well, I've made a few modifications to my mechanics since our last encounter. So back off or be deleted.
Yep, engine again. Like, I get what they were trying to do, like Crash 2, Crash 3. You get Cortex's like main henchman, and then you fight Cortex himself, but considering Entropy's like significance to the plot, I think it would have just been better if he was the fourth boss instead of Engine, but hey, I get what they were trying to do. What would be even better is because since this is actually the first game where you actually have to fight Cortex twice if you want to get the true ending, it would have been nicer if like the second time you fight him it was harder or his like the attacks came out faster or they did different attacks entirely to make it different. I don't know, like if it was a different fight, I think it would have been more interesting. Like, I don't know, you could have had the Cortex fight, the true ending Cortex fight in the secret walkroom and the regular one in the fifth walkroom like it is normally. But I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I feel like if they did that, it would have been a lot better. But yeah, I just love future levels. I don't know, can't really explain why, I just like the aesthetics, and the music's pretty neat. Those things that force you into a spin. Also, nearly everything basically just disintegrates you. It's pretty hardcore, actually. If that's the right word. Dang it. I mean, I guess you could kind of compare these things to the things in Crash 1 in the factory levels. They kind of look like it, but they're a lot bigger. But I guess it's the future, so they have some enhancements. They can actually do an attack now. So, woo! Almost missed it. I don't really like the fact that they have to have those, like, sign things there. Because it's just, like, I'd like to figure out how to go through these bonus stages on my own without the game, like, holding my hand like that. It's kind of like in Sonic Heroes, where they, even in, like, Mystic Mansion, Eggfleet, and all those stages, they still seem to want to show you, like, those, like, formation signs, and to tell you, like, which formation works for that section. And I'm just like, man, I just want to figure this stuff out on my own. I don't want you to just flat out tell me, you know? I was too slow. And that was bad. I don't even know what I'm bothering. I can't even get the gem on this. Okay. Oh, I love doing that triple bounce. And now for the last level. And this is a, it's meant to be an Egyptian level, but it more or less feels like its own theme, because it's the only level that has a level gimmick like this, where the water is constantly rising and lowering, and you have to be careful not to drown, basically. And there aren't any other, there's not really another stage like this. And yeah, no. Yeah, we're gonna have to restart, because this is another stage that has a death root. Like, there's only 3 actual death roots in the game, but there's like 4, 6 or so as you count, like, optional areas and, like, the secret warp room stuff. But yeah. Or maybe more, I could be wrong. No, like, the gem pathways are more or less they're more or less as hard as death roots most of the time, so you can count those as well, I guess. I don't know. It all depends on what you count as a death root. Yep. Ooh, that was close. Okay, make sure you get that first. This might be the bonus stage I was thinking of, because I don't think there's another. Well, there's another Egyptian level, but I know it's not the one with a difficult bonus room, because it's doing a completely different gimmick. It's funny how the Egyptian levels get, like, so many stages. Alright. Yeah, this is really difficult to pull off, and you'll see why. This part. Yeah, I screwed up the easiest part. I don't think the bonus rooms screw up the death route. I'm gonna hope they don't. Alright. And it's nice that the boxes are, like, right on, like, there's no way you could have gotten the Wumpa Fruit if they just, like, spread out everywhere. So it's nice that they just made it so you just got them instantly. Okay. Now, because this is so dangerous, it's because of these. And look how tight that can be. Like, I'm surprised I did that in one go. Well, technically two goes, but, you know, that's the first time of me actually going through that, trying to avoid the nitros. I'm not taking any chances here. I can, if I was ballsy enough, I could try and jump on the beetle and the boxes and survive, but that's way too risky. I'm not gonna take it. It really puts things into perspective when, say, when you can't die, you really want to be more careful, and it just makes you play the game, like, completely differently. Like, yeah, here we go. If, Crush 1 didn't have that stupid gem mechanic, then I probably would be playing the game a lot more recklessly, or just trying to do a lot more cool tricks and stuff. But the fact that I can't die basically makes it so I want to take it a bit slower. Also, I don't know what people are talking about when they say the death fruit disappears on POW. Like, they say, like, when you go on a death route, but die in it, it'll just disappear in the level. You can't do it again. I don't know what they're talking about, because that's... Yeah, I know. I'm playing the PAL version on disc. So I don't know. I don't know what people are talking about with that. Maybe it's a later copy? That's a bit far-fetched, if you ask me. I don't think they changed it. Could be wrong. But yeah, I just... Like, even back then, I'm pretty sure there weren't... that didn't happen. Alright. Actually, no. I like how the music just kind of resets itself. All right. Now we have three colored gems, I think. Alright, now we can be a little bit more reckless. And that crystal sound effect, like, in Crash 2 it was just a kind of a generic ching sound or something, but now it's a I don't know, I'm bad at mimicking sound effects, but it just sounds so satisfying. I keep thinking I'm gonna jump on that. It's too low. Alright, there we go. Let's see if I can do this, actually. Way off. Alright. boy! Man, this stage is a lot longer than I thought it was. Come on! Oh man, that was way too close. And if I miss a box. Okay, please be enough. Yes. Now, this is my favorite boss in the game. You'll see. You'll see why.
So, you want to go a few rounds? When this is over, we'll see who's obsolete.
You. So, this is the only boss where we have to... where we fight with Coco, and... good luck hearing anything because of the noises, but yeah, it's basically a space battle. You're flying on the moon and just... it may be completely different from a regular Crash boss, but it's just so... I think it's just really well designed. It's a lot better than the engine fighting Crash 2, even though I think that boss is also the best in that game. That's the best boss in Crash 2 as well. Funny that, but yeah, I just think this is the most enjoyable fight in the game. It just feels so good just destroying engines, machine thing. But the impact of your shots just feels so satisfying. And it's actually, well, it's not too difficult, but for a first-time player, this can be pretty challenging. Alright. And you want to get rid of that, the diamond thing in the engine shoots out of the bottom, because That can get rid of half of your health. So, yeah, I want to get rid of that. Also, fun fact, for some reason as a kid, I always thought it was pronounced engine. I have no idea why. Because, like, engine, that's the whole joke. Yeah.
Not again.
Lol. Also, yeah, Pura just appears to give you more firepower. Because, yeah, it does make your shots more powerful.
It's funny how history repeats itself. Yet again, Engine has failed to defeat you.
For this, we must destroy you.
Oh, my aching head. I'm not feeling myself these days. So, the end is in sight. Gather another 5 crystals, and again you will have foiled my plan. Or will you?
Dun dun dun!